Blackstone Audio presents The Quantum Moment, How Planck, Bohr, Einstein, and Heisenberg Taught Us to Love Uncertainty, by Robert P. Crease and Alfred Scharff Goldhaber. This book is read by Sean Runnette. To our students, whose spirit and insight enlivened our course and this book. Introduction. Not long ago, the two of us were in a classroom listening to our students give their final presentations, which had to consist of original work. Two students read short plays. One performed a hip-hop song. Others created artwork in various media. One student, who was being treated for schizophrenia, explained bravely, haltingly, what it is like to suffer from the disease, using the language of superposed states and quantum mechanics, bringing the typically boisterous and chatty class to dead silence. The next presentation was by a pair of science majors who donned safety goggles, poured liquid nitrogen on a special kind of magnet, which is a type 2 superconductor, and demonstrated quantum levitation, explaining the Abrikosov-Meissner effect on which it is based. In between, students made jokes about references to quantum topics that they'd found, including web pages about things like quantum beer and quantum jazz. The last project was by a mechanical engineering major. He brought a stack of odds and ends that he said he had thrown together, Pepsi bottles, eyeglasses, scotch tape, a ping-pong ball, to the front of the room. He astounded the class by shining a flashlight on the stack from a particular perspective, and it projected a clear image of a cat against the wall. These projects were the final assignment for the Quantum Moment, a class that we've co-taught for half a dozen years. An elective open to physics and philosophy majors, it attracts a diverse range of students. Humanities students who take it are intrigued about what the word quantum means. Science students who take it want to know whether and why a scientific term can really be applied to human behavior. Other students are drawn by the catchy title, or because the course satisfies certain requirements and fits their jammed schedules. The course is about the cultural impact of the quantum. The quantum, the name for the fact that energy comes in finite packages and is not infinitely divisible, was introduced in 1900 to explain puzzling results in a remote corner of physics about how light is emitted and absorbed. Two quantum revolutions followed. The first occurred between 1900 and 1925, when scientists discussed and developed the theory without attracting much public attention. Then, in 1925-27, the theory was transformed by a second revolution, called quantum mechanics, whose bizarre implications became the subject of public curiosity and discussion. Even today, over 80 years later, humanity is still unsure what to make of the second quantum revolution, finding it puzzling, visionary, and even shocking. New books about the quantum appear almost monthly. The word quantum is applied to everyday life in plays, poetry, movies, painting, fiction, music, philosophy, numerous company names, and pop science approaches to psychology and neuroscience. Heisenberg's uncertainty principle, Schrödinger's cat, parallel worlds, and other concepts and images of quantum mechanics show up on t-shirts and coffee cups, in cartoons, novels, poems, and movies. They are found on failblog.org, a showcase of cultural memes. In the American television drama series Breaking Bad, Heisenberg is the pseudonym of the protagonist, a high school chemistry teacher who manufactures and sells the illegal drug crystal methamphetamine. In March 2012, a New York Times opinion article argued that quantum terminology was the correct way to describe the campaign and personality of presidential candidate Mitt Romney. "For we have entered the age of quantum politics, and Mitt Romney is the first quantum politician." President Barack Obama, who defeated Romney in the November 2012 election, in interviews, has invoked Heisenberg's principle to explain how he seeks guidance from advisors. In the 21st century, we ask our class, why does the idea of the quantum still appear as a metaphor in the human realm, wild and mysterious, packed with creative force? Our readings vary from semester to semester, but include books and articles on history, philosophy, and sociology, several plays, including Michael Frayn's Copenhagen, and have included works of fiction, such as Neal Stephenson's Anathem. We provide background for how diverse concepts and images, the uncertainty principle, complementarity, Schrödinger's cat, parallel universes, sprang from the quantum idea. We ask students to think carefully about how quantum language and imagery is used and abused. In the article entitled, How You Get That Story, Heisenberg's Uncertainty Principle and the Literature of the Vietnam War, what insight does this reference add to understanding journalism? Is the use of parallel worlds in movies such as Another Earth and Rabbit Hole an incisive, semi-scientific plot twist or distracting ornament? The students' final projects involve creating, singly or in groups, a quantum-inspired work of their own. In addition to the ones already mentioned, they have also written songs, created multimedia presentations, decorated clothing, and created performance art by spouting or spoofing quantum nonsense. One year, students made a video about a second-year physics major, played by a second-year physics major, trying to learn the meaning of quantum mechanics. He goes into Stony Brook's physics help room, an actual place, hoping a good tutor will be on hand that day. An English major, played by an English major, rushes up to him. English major, thank God you're here. I have to tell somebody. I just read this article on quantum mechanics. You're never going to believe this. With Newton, everything was certain, but now with quantum mechanics, nothing is certain anymore. There's this Heisenberg uncertainty principle, and I mean, I could go outside, and there's not even an outside. I left my dorm today, and it was sunny, and now, pointing to her umbrella, it's probably raining. Physics major, exasperated. It's a beautiful day outside, I promise. English major, everything is uncertain now. With Newton it was fine, and now it's not fine anymore. Am I a particle or a wave? Are you even real? Physics major, irritated. You're fine, I'm fine, your hamster's fine, your dorm's fine. English major, suddenly widening her eyes. My hamster! My dorm! I don't know what my hamster is doing right now. It's all a mess.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.